Okay, good morning, guys. It's 4:06 in the morning on May 19th. It's day 46. It's 55 degrees even, and I'm going to wake up. Okay, good morning again, folks. 5:15, holding steady at 55 degrees even, just breaking out of camp. Slept great last night. Never got super cold, but there was a nice sort of like just dragging, cool slide of air that kind of just stayed pouring down the hill ever so gently all night long, which was really nice. Heard a couple animals running around, but nothing spooky, probably just like squirrels or lizards or something. Slept great, woke up this morning, got my breakfast all dialed in, camp all packed up. Now I'm hiking. Wound up having the place to myself last night. That group of three came through maybe 30 minutes or so after I got to camp. Apparently they had been, go figure, man, they had earmarked that spot that I was in as their stopping point for the night as well. So, I mean, we could have really smushed three more, but definitely it would have been everyone cowboy camping, and it would have been pretty close proximity, and well, they made the decision to keep hiking just another quarter mile or so. There's another spot, and I gather from the fact that they did not return last night that they wound up finding that place adequate, stayed there. Whatever, it's fine. I hear some water here. Speaking of water, it's about 10 miles or so to my first water source, which is going to be up and over the top of this mountain. Gosh, this water is pretty much just mud. Up and over the top of this mountain. Right now I'm kind of earmarked looking at 23 miles or so, which would be up and over the top of the second mountain as well. But, yeah, that put me definitely in spitting distance of Kennedy Meadows. And I don't think I'm going to wind up pushing and rolling into Kennedy today because there just doesn't seem like a whole great reason to do that. But it's kind of on my radar as a possibility because after that second mountain, it's just downhill and flat all the way into Kennedy. That would make it a 32-mile day if I decide to do that, but I don't think I'm going to, but we'll see. That's about all I got. I'm going to get hiking, and I will definitely talk to you guys later. All right, it's 4:11, 79.4 degrees. I've made it to home for the night. Not quite in the fashion I would have preferred, but it's fine. Still did my 20, whatever it was, 23 miles or something like that to make it to what was earmarked as my original sort of stopping point over here at Manter Creek, which is northbound mile 694.7 for those of you inclined to think in terms of mile markers. But got here and it was beautiful. It was a big group of like, I don't know what, maybe 15 people or something here as of 10 minutes ago or so, but pretty quickly clocked pretty bad clouds that were just opening up over the mountains, and definitely it looked like the wind was blowing them in. So some more clouds over this way, and just now feeling raindrops, so I decided to go ahead and pitch up the tent out of an abundance of caution. I would have preferred to have gone another three and a half miles to some more tent sites or whatever, but really, I've never been so desperate to do 3 miles that I'll ignore the signs that Mother Nature gives me. So, anyways, there's the tent pitched up. Hopefully that deep rolling thunder came out for you, but not sure, actually. It might just kind of blow over. The more I'm looking at it, the more it looks like it might not actually be a thing. But again, all I can do is make my decision with the information I have available at the time, and I stand by this decision. So I'm camped up just a touch under 9 miles from Kennedy Meadows, and that's just fine, dude, just fine. I already cooked up dinner, but it's just sitting there doing its thing. It's couscous, so it'll be just a couple minutes before I eat it. Looks like the rain's picking up just a touch. If it picks up a touch more, I'll dive into the tent, but hopefully we don't need to do that. We'll see. That's all I got for today. Talk to you tomorrow.